Hello everyone. So when we left off, we have our objects in the corner here, but they're not labeled or anything, so we need to label them. How are we going to label them? Well, we're going to go ahead and put some GUI objects in. We're going to make it the responsibility of the inventory object to actually do that, but we don't want our inventory object to always show it. So we're not going to use the onGUI command or the onGUI script function. Instead, we're going to actually just make it a special function that gets called by inventory whenever it wants the unit to display. But we are going to need to know what our bounds are for displaying. So we're going to pass in a rectangle, and that'll just tell the inventory object what kind of space it has to work with. And we're going to put a label at the top, which is going to be extent.x, extent.y, extent.width, and 20. GUI.label, label, comma, screen name. And that will simply print our screen name to the top of our window. But we need to actually call this function, and we need to pass in the extent. So over here in inventory, we need to create the onGUI. This function will get called multiple times per frame because it's the standard Unity GUI command. And the first thing we need to do is, if we're not currently active, we don't care. We want it to go away if we're not currently active. If we are active, however, we need to go through and tell the inventory objects to show themselves. But we don't have a rect. We need a rect. Okay. Get. We don't have this function yet, so let's go ahead and build it. So by taking in the transform of the object, we know where in the world it is, and we can put a box around it that is at the right spot on our screen. So now we know exactly where our object is in terms of where it is on the screen. So the question is, do we want to pass a vector 3 center, or do we want to pass a rectangle? Do we want to actually calculate out 1 meter off to the side and all that stuff? In this case, I think it's easiest if we just fiat the rectangle. We can always make it more adaptable later. Let's just say it's 50 pixels wide. And now that's very much a fiat. I'm not going to go ahead and try and calculate it out at this point. But later on, when we start to do adaptive interfaces, that'll probably be something that gets replaced with a more careful set of tools. But let's see how that. Nope, it didn't look like anything. Oh, void. Me smart. All right, so where is that question mark? Oh, look, it's down at the bottom. Why is it down at the bottom? Well, because the Y has been reversed. As I said, the world and screen coordinates, the y-axis is always reversed. And so you have to understand exactly how we're reaching a certain y position and make sure to reverse it at the right moment. If we reversed it down here, we'd be reversing it after we subtracted 50 from it. So that would mean that we're actually adding 50 to it. Instead, we need to reverse it up here. And we hit tab, and then you can see that the question mark is in the right spot. Now our actual rectangles are a little bit too short, so we can expand them a little bit. So we can say negative 70 and 140, which will give us a little bit more space to play around with. The other thing we can do here is we want to add in the description. So label equals new rect, label dot y equals extent dot y plus extent dot height minus 60, label dot height equals 60, and then GUI dot label desk. That should auto wrap. Now this description is pretty short, and right now it just says one thing. But one of the problems you can already see is that it doesn't have any box around it or anything, so it's hard to make out. It's also very large in terms of how big the text is. So let's go ahead and make the text smaller as well as making it a box. And the way we do that is we say GUI.box. And you can see that the box doesn't wrap, and it's got a couple of other issues with it shows off that the width of these is actually not ideal. But that's all fixable. What we're going to do is we're going to create a GUI skin. The GUI skin lets us create a much more suitable interface and will allow us to fix it up later on to look like what we'd like it to look like. So we're going to call this one the item menu skin. And this is a default skin when you first start it up. So let's go ahead and just put it onto the inventory. Like so. And then we can actually just add it in by dragging it over to here. And over here in our inventory objects, actually here in the, it's getting loud again, hold on. All right. So over here in GUI, we can assign our GUI that skin. There we go. And that should last through all instances until someone else changes it away. So we don't need to worry about the inventory objects understanding that that GUI exists, that GUI skin rather exists. So in our GUI skin, let's go ahead and make a couple of small changes. Let's go ahead and rename this to item menu skin. Since the skins are very rare, it's hard for me to remember what the icon is. So we can go ahead and edit this to look like however we want it to look like. And the biggest thing we want to change here is that we want to make it so that it wraps the text. There it is, word wrap. So now when we hit play, we should have it so that it wraps. And you can see that it wraps fine, and it's also centered. If we don't want it to be centered, it's quite easy for us to change it from upper center to left or whatever else we would like. But we do need to really shrink this text size. It's much too large. Let's go ahead and set this from 0 to 10 and see what happens. I'm sure you'll just put up with the sound of my mostly deaf landlady in the background today. You can see that the text is very small. That's probably too small. What happens if we change it to 12? I think that's the same size it was before, so let's go for 11. And you can edit this. Also, you can change the font for more clarity. Arial's not the best at these low... Was that Arial? I think it was. At the low resolutions, there are other fonts that are slightly better. Another thing we need to do is this is too wide, so we're going to change it to 40 and 80. Alright, where was I? I think we were actually just about done. The only thing we really want to do is change it from saying undescribed object to something useful. Another thing we can do if we would like is we can make the whole thing into a button. We'll discuss that in the next episode, but for this episode, the last thing we're going to do is we're going to make it so that these actually have a definition. month of goods, I guess. That might be too long. Let's take a look. Just the right size. Now this can obviously be adapted to whatever we want. We can make it so that these are larger or smaller as we please. We can adjust the text. We can change whether or not we want it to do any of the various things we want it to do. But in the next episode, what we'll probably end up doing is, right now, if you were to click on that, it works, but if you were to click down here, nothing would happen. So in the next episode, we'll probably make it so that these can be clicked on using the on-GUI click rather than the on-update click. So we'll see that in the next episode.